Life is full of stress. Some of it's good. Constructive energy that gets us off our backsides and stimulates us into action. But when it builds up too much, it can turn against us and become distress. The kind of stress that makes us perform under par and sometimes stops us cold. I guess we all suffer from stress. I know I do. I'm in a business where stress is literally the name of the game. Performing, getting up in front of people, getting rattled before talk shows, putting myself on the line as such, hanging it out over the edge and holding on for dear life. Oh yeah, you could say I've got stress. How many times have I stood up in front of a camera with no spit, my mouth dry as a bone, or waited in the wings before a live performance and felt the tension just rising up the back of my neck and my throat closing? Oh yeah, stress is an old friend, or I should say enemy. It sent me to the chiropractor and through a whole catalog of pills and painkillers, had me flat on my back in bed, had my hand shaking so bad I couldn't even hold my eyebrow pencil, and had me paralyzed with fear. Who says I don't have stress? So what does one do? Well, I'm about to tell you. Over the years, thanks to my background in yoga, which has always provided the basis of my fitness routine, I've learned to control these anxiety attacks, these unsuspecting moments of panic, when even if I plan ahead, I'm caught off guard, thrown off balance. You see, actually, we all go through these deadly assaults on our senses, and they send us out of control, which is why I decided to make this video. Okay. There is a way to manage stress, to control it, instead of letting it control you. There are medically proven techniques to help you get the upper hand when pressures of work, family, children, personal relationships, and bad news, and even tragedy affect us and threaten our whole health and sense of well-being. Personally, I found that these techniques really work to relieve stress in the body by relaxing tensions in the mind and remind us how the mind and body interact on each other, how deeply connected body and mind always are. Since I started practicing these techniques myself, I found that they noticeably improve the quality of my life, both professionally and personally. They've given, and they continue to give me, the tools I need to control my own reaction and attitude to things, instead of letting outside influences or inner fears overwhelm me. They're so simple, I'd like to share them with you, and outline the method so that you can easily follow along, learn them, and practice them whenever you need to. But first, I'd like to introduce someone who, in my research, became happily my collaborator and inspiration. She's the author of the best-selling book, Minding the Body, Mending the Mind. She holds a doctorate of anatomy in cellular biology from Harvard Medical School, is a pioneer of a new fascinating medical discipline called psychoneuroimmunology, and is one of the foremost specialists in the field of stress control techniques. Dr. Joan Borisenko. Hi, Joan.
Hi, Raquel.
It's so nice to have you with us here today. I had heard someplace that there were like 95 million Americans a week that were going to doctors for stress-related illnesses of all kind, from colds and minor problems to very severe illnesses that were aggravated by stress.
That's right. Also, what we're beginning to find out is that stress can even affect the functioning of your body's immune system. And it's the immune system that's your first line of resistance against outside invaders like viruses or bacteria.
I think this is so fascinating. But could you just tell me what stress really is? What is stress?
The technical definition of stress is twofold. One of them is the feeling that we're being threatened, either in body or in mind. Mm-hmm. The second part of that is that we feel helpless to control the stress. So it's two things, it's threat and lack of control. Now when that goes on in terms of our whole life, when we chronically feel like I can't control what's happening to me, I feel helpless, I feel victimized, the body goes through a set of chronic changes, not only chronic muscle tension, talked about I get tension here too, but things like hormonal changes. The level of corticosteroids in your body goes up. Most everybody has used cortisone cream for a bug bite or poison ivy. That decreases the potency of your immune response. Now, if you're making all of this cortisone in your body all the time because you're chronically stressed, it's no wonder that you're likely to be more susceptible to a whole range of diseases, everything from colds and flus to headaches to high blood pressure, and even a disease like multiple sclerosis, most people will tell you, can be made worse by stress. By the same token, there's good news. And the good news is that studies have shown even when you practice relaxation techniques as infrequently as 3 times a week, you can improve immune function. One study showed more than a doubling in the kind of immune cell, the natural killer cell, that fights off viruses and tumor-infected cells. That's pretty remarkable. 3 periods of meditation, a doubling.
That's amazing. Joan, stress is caused by lots of things, but isn't it also caused by change? And isn't there a kind of list of cosmic changes, shall
yes.
we call them, that affect people and cause stress?
Yes. For instance, at the top of the list would be death of a spouse, the most stressful thing that can happen to anybody. Then there would be things like personal illness or injury, taking out a mortgage, getting married. Getting married ranks fairly high on the stress list. And then the little minor hassles of life, getting a parking ticket, for instance. But if you take a look at that list, you'll find an award, an honor, an achievement, a promotion. All of those things add to stress too, because they're readjustments. Your life is going to be different.
Changes.
Changes. I had a bank teller once who just won $50,000 in the lottery. She said it was the worst thing that ever happened to her, because now she was fighting with her husband over what kind of house to buy, and before her life had been so simple. And so anything that creates change creates a challenge. And then it is our own coping ability that makes that challenge either a stress or an experience of growth.
In the video, we talk about the relaxation response and show a few simple ways, but there are many ways to induce this response, Joan.
You know, it wasn't too long ago, Raquel, maybe the mid-1960s, when it was really believed that the mind and the body don't affect one another. It's hard to really believe how we could have thought this scientifically, because all of us know, gee, I have a scary thought and my heart beats more quickly. It seems obvious. But it used to be thought that it was also impossible for the mind to influence the body in a voluntary way. For instance, to change your blood pressure, to change your heart rate. Biofeedback changed all of that. And in the mid-1960s, Dr. Herbert Benson did really the first biofeedback experiment with monkeys. And what he showed was that you could train monkeys to actually keep their blood pressure elevated to a certain level. And we know now that we have much more control of the body than what we have ever thought before. When we feel centered and calm in ourselves, when we're not controlled by our anxiety, the body also comes to balance. It's called homeostasis. What Benson found was that simple relaxation techniques restored the sense of homeostasis to the body. And he called that the relaxation response. Just as there's a physiology to fight or flight, where heart rate and blood pressure and all of those kinds of metabolic increases occur, there's a similar physiology to the relaxation response. Heart rate goes down, blood pressure goes down, your hormones change. You're making less adrenaline, less of that cortisone, and even the electrical activity in the brain changes toward a more relaxed and creative kind of state. Now, what's wonderful is that we can do this naturally. So we're not always walking in a sunset or having one of those great moments of connectedness.
Unfortunately not.
But there are other techniques which you're going to be showing people in the videos. Techniques of breathing, of concentration that bring you back to the moment and elicit this healthful state of physiology and peace of mind.
The relaxation response.
That's right.
Through the breathing.
Right.
Why is breathing so important? Why is it the keynote that we've selected to base this whole video around?
Breathing is the gateway between the conscious and the unconscious, between the voluntary control of our body and the body's own inner wisdom. Let me give you an example. You can't say to your body, okay, I would like you to have a heart rate of 68 beats per minute. You can't command your blood pressure, well, I want you to be at such and such a reading. The only involuntary activity of the body over which you also have conscious control is the breathing, right? I mean, it happens day and night without stop, whether you're aware of it or not. But you can also say, wait, I can take a letting go breath. As you're going to show people on the video, I can move into a relaxed form of diaphragmatic breathing. When you do that, breathing just the way that a baby breathes, your heart rate will go down, your blood pressure will go down, your nervous system activity will regularize, you'll elicit the relaxation response. What could be simpler?
I think you're so right. I want to thank you, Joan, for your invaluable contribution to this video. It's been just terrific to work with you on designing this very special program.
You're welcome. I've enjoyed the process very much, too. And I know that this tape is going to be very helpful to all the people who watch it.
I really hope so. And so now that you have the background on this subject, you're ready to embark on this relaxation program and on your way to stress relief. Scientists agree that the body and mind are connected and interact on one another, as we discussed. And we will concentrate on that connection in this video, which is divided into two different segments, the body and the mind. The first part deals with the body. It emphasizes physical techniques and exercises to help you reduce your muscular tension and induce the relaxation response. You'll learn to relieve tension in the body while quieting the mind. The second part, immediately following, focuses on the mind. It concentrates primarily on mental relaxation to help you release emotional and psychological stress and bring about a sense of peaceful awareness between your mind and your body. That's the key to complete relaxation. Both segments are best practiced in combination with each other and, once you've learned them and mastered them, can be taken into your everyday life, wherever and whenever you feel the need to relax or want just an anti-stress fix. My advice is that whether you're a beginner or already familiar with these techniques, it's a good idea to look through the video first before embarking on the exercises, since what you're about to see and experience is a very comprehensive program. So just look at it and get acquainted. Then, when you feel ready, choose a quiet moment to start your practice. I find that the mornings are best, before the onslaught of another day, when the world and the phone are still quiet. But whichever time you feel is most convenient is the right time for you to start. And wear comfortable clothing. Pick a very special private place in your home where you won't be disturbed. No kids, no animals, no one. If necessary, unplug that telephone. Remove your wristwatch, and remember to give yourself permission to take this time for yourself. This is your opportunity to finally spend time alone, to finally just be you. So now we're almost ready to start. But before we do, I'd like to bring your attention to something that we've all taken for granted. but something that we need to focus on now, because it's the key, in fact, the cornerstone to this complete relaxation and stress relief. The all-important bridge between body and mind. Can you guess what that is? What we do unconsciously, that we carry with us wherever we go, something we even do while we're sleeping? Breathing. Breathing is the only real place to start. It's the beginning of life, and therefore, naturally, the beginning of this learning process. But you may ask, what's there to learn about breathing? After all, we trust that we exhale and inhale automatically, involuntarily, every second of our lives. Is there such a thing as breathing wrong? You bet there is. Try, for example, to remember for a moment the last time you were truly frightened, or anxious, or even angry. Chances are you either held your breath, stopped it altogether, or that your breathing became very fast and shallow. Perhaps you even felt your chest burning, hurting. You are experiencing heavy stress chest breathing. Now, think about the way a baby is breathing, asleep in its crib, peaceful. Do you recall how its tummy slowly expands like a small balloon? And when it breathes out, its tummy gently flattens down. This is abdominal relaxed breathing. It's relaxing just thinking about it, isn't it? Unfortunately, somewhere along the way to adulthood, with all the hurries and responsibilities, mortgage payments and job promotions, the family, the kids, we just forgot how to breathe. Our anxious minds took over. Well, here's the chance to recapture your natural breathing all over again. Okay, first, let's identify the way we usually breathe. Find yourself a straight back chair, one that comfortably supports your posture, and then slide forward a few inches so that you're just slightly reclining. You can put a pillow behind your lower back, if you like. Place one hand palm down below your navel and place the other hand on your chest like this. Without trying to change your breathing in any way, simply bring your attention to it and notice whether your belly is expanding or flattening as you inhale. If you would enjoy closing your eyes while you're doing this, it may help you concentrate. Keep breathing normally and start noticing if your belly expands as you breathe in. And if it does, you're breathing at least in part from your diaphragm. If your belly doesn't move or even goes flat as you inhale, you're breathing from your chest, like most of us. Now, let's try something. Take a big breath in and then blow it out all through your mouth, like a big sigh. As you did this, did you notice how your belly flattened? Flatten it even further by squeezing every little bit of air out of it. Now just let the next breath flow in naturally, automatically by itself, through your nose. Can you feel your belly expand when your breath flows in? Try it again. Watch me. And then relax, let go. Keep your hand on your belly. And notice now how it slowly rises with each in-breath and gently falls by itself with each out-breath. Can you feel the difference? You're now breathing with your abdomen. Try again. Hand on your belly. Take one deep breath in. And now blow it out through your mouth with a big sigh of relief. Make all the noise you want. See the movement? Feel it under your hand. Good. Keep going. Relax with it. Let your eyes close and keep your attention on the natural rise and fall of your breath. Feel your body rise and fall. Begin to feel the natural comfort of your body as it relaxes into the chair. Every out-breath is a chance to let go, to relax. Give up, little by little. And remember that this state of peacefulness is really there all the time. Remember where your natural state is, and always has been, just waiting for you to tap in. Become aware of the natural rhythm of your breath. As you breathe in, your belly expands and gently relaxes back as you breathe out. Imagine a balloon blowing up gently in your belly on your in-breath and slowly relaxing back on the out-breath. Breathe in, and on the out-breath, silently repeat the number 10. Letting go of all your tension. Like a wave that ebbs and flows, moving from your head all the way through your body, down to the soles of your feet. Breathe in again, feel your belly expand. And as you breathe out, silently count 9. Relax even more and feel your body sink further into the chair. Let gravity do the work for you. In again, and mentally imagine 8 now as you breathe out. Continue breathing normally now. 7. 6. 5. 4. 3. 2. One. Now you can slowly open your eyes. How do you feel? Much more relaxed, right? Observe how your breathing has slowed down. Feel like a little yawn? Or even like falling asleep? That's just a sign that you've unlocked the relaxation response. As you become more familiar with this simple breathing technique, you'll be able to practice it laying down, standing up in an elevator, sitting behind the wheel of your car, or even at your desk at work, anytime, anywhere that you feel the need to relax. Therefore, I recommend that before you decide to embark on the rest of the program, you first try practicing this portion of the tape again tomorrow and the day after, as often as you like, little by little, until abdominal relaxation breathing has almost become second nature or your best friend. Quite frankly, if you only learned this exercise out of the entire video, you will have already opened the door to total relaxation. So enjoy. Have you been practicing your abdominal breathing? Good. Ready to start? All right then. Welcome to part 1. In this segment, we're going to focus our attention on the body, and I'm going to lead you through a series of gentle stretches based on Hatha Yoga. All through this series, I will remind you to breathe, to stay aware of your breathing, and to use every opportunity of letting go of tension and stress on the out-breath, as you just learned to do. Okay? Now remember, you're not in competition with anyone here. There's no need to strain, push, or force yourself. Just do the best you can. Relaxation is definitely a non-competitive business. So learn at your own pace. Don't strive. Just enjoy doing it. The process is its own reward. Now that we're ready to begin, make sure you won't be interrupted. If you have an exercise mat, great. Or a large towel would do just as well. Place it on the floor, and let's start our routine with a deep breathing exercise. This exercise is to prepare and condition your body for the stretches ahead. First, let me demonstrate. Stand with your feet together. Interlock your fingers and place them under your chin. Now breathe in to the count of six and feel the breath vibrate off the back of the throat. Watch me. Now exhale and whisper the word ah. Ah. Got it? Okay, let's begin. Hands under the chin and... I know, you may feel a little uncoordinated in the beginning, but don't judge yourself. You're just learning. Just go with the flow. It's nice to know that even if you don't think you're doing this posture well, you're still getting the benefits. Just ride along on the rhythm of your breath. Down to your side. How do you feel? Just stretch it out. Relax all the tensions away. Good. Now we're ready for the next posture, which is the reed pose. Keep standing with your legs together and arms over the head. Stretch up, interlock your fingers. Inhale. And stretch to the left. Feel any areas of tension along the side of your body and release them on each exhalation, each out-breath as you stretch. Come up, inhale, and stretch, and over to the other side. Now feel the tight areas on the other side and breathe through. Relax into the pose on every exhale. And come up. Inhale and over to the front. everything in slow motion. Let your head hang loosely on your neck now. And relax your shoulders. And breathe. And uncurl. Back up again. Hello. Ah. How are you doing? Good. And next we're going to do some head rolls. So stay standing just as you are. Inhale. And very gently exhale. Inhale. Inhale when you bring your head up, and exhale on the release. The neck is a prime area for tension, so just breathe and release. And to the side. Relax. Inhale and exhale. Don't force anything. Inhale. Let your shoulders drop. Inhale. And to the side. And back to center. Now we're ready to get down onto the mat. Just kneel down on all fours, knees about equal distance as hands. And we're going to do the cat pose, which is just stretching like a big cat. Inhale. Exhale. Let your back arch. Inhale. Press your spine up through the ceiling. And exhale. Stick out your bottom behind you now. Press the heels of your hand into the floor. Doesn't that feel good? And now just come the rest of the way down on your mat and relax for a second. Head to the side. We're going to do the cobra pose. Place your hands on the mat just next to your chest. Straighten your head. Inhale and press up. Exhale. Look to the ceiling and point your toes. Stretch all along the front of your body. And come down very, very slowly. Head to the side and relax. Sink into the floor and breathe. And once again, place your hand next to your chest. Straighten your head. Inhale and
to press up on the exhale. Press your pelvic bone into the floor. And very gently come down again. And relax. And now, we're going to lie down on our backs for the knee squeeze. Legs straight ahead of you, and just lie back very gently. And relax. And now, bend your right leg, pull it to your chest. Feel your shoulders press into the floor. Keep breathing, exhaling, and relaxing. And now the other knee. Feel every vertebrae in your back relax into the floor and breathe. And now bend both legs. And press your hips toward the floor as you hold onto your knees. And now place your hands underneath your knees. Kick up and rock forward. And two, and three, and four. Good. That was to massage your lower back where you hold all that tension. And now move to the back of the mat because we're going to do the rabbit pose. Sit back on your heels. Reach around behind you. Take a hold of them with your hands. Chin to the chest and rock forward. Very gently, keeping your weight in your hands as they grip the feet. Rest your head on the floor and curl. Relax and breathe. Feel the circulation come into the head and shoulders. And roll up vertebrae by vertebrae. Hello. How are you feeling? Much more relaxed, right? Oh, that feels good. And now you're going to sit on your mat for the leg extensions. Leg to the side, the other foot into the thigh. Inhale, arms over the head, stretch up, and bend over the leg. Just take a hold of your leg wherever it's comfortable. Don't strain. Feel the stretch and breathe. Relax. And very gently, come back up and change your legs. Other leg out, this leg into the thigh. Inhale, bring your arms up, stretch and if you're not as flexible as you might like to be, don't worry.
just do the best you can. Breathe, exhale, and relax.
And come back up again. And arms down to the side, relax. And now we're going to do a very simple version of the spinal twist. So come forward on your mat or towel. Lie back. Arms out to the side like a T. And just bend one leg. Place it over the other knee. And roll.
While you're lying there, be aware of what's happening in your body. Areas of tension. And breathe. And relax.
And roll back. Bend the other leg. Place it over the other knee. And roll.
You may feel areas of tightness in the neck, the hips, the shoulders. Feel the twist in your spine. And relax.
And come back to the center. And second set. Arms to the side. Leg over. And roll.
Feel the stretch all along the diagonal angle of your body. Let gravity do the work for you.
And come back. Roll to the other side.
And relax. And breathe into the movement of the pose.
And leg back to the center. And now, just relax into the floor in the dead man's pose.
You can now bend your knees and sink your lower back into the floor. If you like, you can close your eyes now and just let yourself go. Give in. Surrender. Concentrate on your breathing. Become aware of the natural rhythm of your breath. And you may notice that the breath has dropped of its own accord to the abdomen. You can help it relax more, become fully abdominal now, as you did before, by just observing your belly go in and out. As you float along, place your hand on your belly if you choose. Stay with your breathing. If perhaps thoughts come, think of yourself sitting by the side of a stream, and any thoughts that come your way are like something remote floating down that stream. Just allow them to float there, passing by, and concentrate on your breathing. Letting it flow. Focusing on the breath. Observing the breath. Feel free at any time to adjust your position for comfort. Be a witness to anything that comes to mind. And just let it be. It has no hold on you. Feel yourself sinking into the floor. The center of your breathing rising and falling. Every time you breathe out, feel the sense of release and sink down into it even more. Become aware of the natural feeling of peace. Ride along effortlessly as your breathing comes and goes, in and out. Feel the balloon filling up gently in your belly and then relaxing back as you breathe out. If you enjoy counting from 10 to 1, as we did before, you might try it now. Breathing in, and then as you breathe out, mentally imagining 10. Nine. Eight. If you lose count, just pick up wherever you think you are. Or if you'd like to make a humming sound, instead. Or perhaps some personal secret word comes to mind. Repeat it silently to yourself on the out-breath. Let yourself feel the comfortable heaviness and warmth of your body. When you breathe out, you can follow your breath down into your own inner silence. Eyes closed, and now move mentally through your body and observe the areas that feel most comfortable. Notice what feels warm and relaxed now. Observe the areas where there might still be a little bit of tension left, and allow them to relax as well. Then use your body as a mirror. Start with your head. Bring the relaxation there and use your breath to deepen it. And to let go even more. Breathe through your areas of tension. Move to your face now. How do you feel? Breathe into your eyes. Feel the warmth and heaviness. Feel your eyelids, your eyebrows, as you breathe out. now let your tongue relax in your throat. Breathe into your jaws. Let your mouth relax and let go. Let your lips part gently. Move the breath now into your neck. And as you breathe out, let the relaxation become deeper and deeper. And now your shoulders. Feel the tension slip away. Let gravity work for you. Your breath is a stream of light, of liquid life. Allow it to move slowly down your arms. Now feeling it in each fingertip. Become aware of the natural flow of life through your chest now. Aware of the feelings of comfort and relaxation. Aware of the areas where you can still let go a little bit more. And if you find such an area of tension, breathe with it and let it melt away. Feel the heaviness of your body deep inside yourself. Sink down and relax deep inside your belly. Move down to your hips now. Your buttocks. Keep slowly moving on each breath down to your legs. Your thighs. Your knees. Let a gentle wave of relaxation flow through your body, all the way down to your feet. Each exhalation deepening your sense of peace. Open yourself up to the energy within, to the life force of your own body. And now, continue to breathe for a few moments in silence. Just enjoying doing nothing. Feeling at peace with yourself and the world around you. Slowly drifting on this warm wave of total relaxation. And if you feel like stretching, do so now. Stretch all the way up, like a big cat, fingers and toes reaching out, and relax. Enjoy the feeling of renewed vitality flowing through your body. You can begin now to come back slowly into the room, Take a nice, deep breath. And when you're ready, roll over gently on your right side and come back up very slowly. And bring that sense of relaxation into the room. Now, if you feel a little lightheaded, do some exhalation breathing with me. Inhale and exhale. How do you feel? And now that you have this wonderful feeling of being renewed, refreshed, and rejuvenated, you can take it with you into your day. It's with you all the time. So whenever you want to get back to that feeling of peace and relaxation, just tap into your breathing for even a moment or two, and you will be transported into that state. We have now concluded the first part of our program. If you want, stay with us for part two of the video, and we'll journey further into total relaxation by reconnecting with our minds. Or if you prefer, you can stop your tape now and wait until tonight, tomorrow, or even next week, continuing to learn and practice part one until you feel comfortable and familiar with it. But whatever you choose, remember, relaxation is not an exercise. It's a new way of life. So now that you've found it, don't go anywhere without it. Welcome back. In this portion of the video, we'll deal with the mind and stress relief. In part one, we emphasized physical techniques designed to relieve stress in the body. You learned to practice abdominal breathing and also how to rely on your breath to induce the relaxation response. You've also learned to recognize and release tension in your body with proven techniques, either centuries old like Hatha Yoga or modern ones like body scanning. Perhaps also, up to this point, you've been to the gym every day, working on your thighs, on your buttocks, your abdominals, your upper arms, and maybe you look pretty good by this time, on the outside. But guess what, folks? We forgot about the mind. You're still not relaxed. You're always a few frustrations or fears away from a bad headache, a neck pain, or even a bout of anxiety. So what have we done wrong? What did we miss? Well, now we'll deal with that invisible friend who sometimes is our worst enemy. The cause of many pains and a lot of physical maladies. In this part of the video, we'll focus on the mind. As we all know by now, the body and the mind are connected for the best and for the worst. But just as you keep your body in shape with diet and exercise, by the same token, you can keep your mind in shape with these mental techniques. So now we'll be concentrating on our old friend, abdominal breathing. And as you proceed with the following breathing session, one thing is certain: every day will be different. Learn to simply observe your thoughts floating in your consciousness. Practice allowing them to drift along without attaching any judgment to them. Choosing to be a witness to your own mind. So now we are about to sit down, stop, let go of the worries and problems, and just be. I have the feeling you're going to be a very good candidate for what's about to follow. Okay, let's start by releasing some tensions in the areas where you feel it the most, in your back, shoulders, and neck, and in the face. These will be simple stretches that you can do anytime, and they're also wonderful before this meditation, because when you let go of your body, your thoughts also begin to quiet down. Let's begin by coming to the edge of the chair. And for the first time you do these exercises, you might want to keep your eyes open to look at me. And then, once you understand the rhythm of the exercise, do them with your eyes closed. Okay, let's start with a spine stretch. So begin by just placing your hands on your thighs or knees, whichever is comfortable. And we're going to stretch and use the breath. Inhale. And collapse forward in slow motion. Stretch up on the inhale, head all the way back. And let your head roll forward again. And relax back one more time. Exhale forward. Good. Now we're going to do shoulder stretches. Another place where we keep a lot of tension is in the shoulders. So now, let's simply roll your shoulders back. Comes very naturally. Ready? Inhale and roll them back. And raise them up to your ears and stretch all the way back. And on the breath, relax your shoulders down again. Good. Now let's go on to some neck stretches. Let's repeat the head rolls that we did in part one for the neck. Inhale. And exhale. Drop your head forward ever so slowly. And now, relax the shoulders. And forward again on the breath. And breathe. Breathe into any tension in the neck. And the side. And to the other side. Exhale. Good. And now let's bring our attention to facial tension. Notice what the feelings are like in your face. The face is a place where we very often hold our emotions. How are you feeling right now? What are your emotions? Can you feel them in your face? Take a minute and let's go to the feelings by massaging gently. First, massaging in the middle of the forehead, little circles. And reverse. And now to the temples. And reverse. And now the jaw joints. And move your fingers to the little hollows in the back of your ears. And now, the back of your neck. Always massaging yourself with the greatest love and care and attention. That feels much better. And now, settle back into your chair. And if your eyes are still open, gently close them now. And become aware of the natural rhythm of your breathing, as you've done before. Bring your attention to the abdomen. Notice how your belly expands as you breathe in and relaxes back with each breath out. Imagine there is a balloon blowing up gently in your belly on your in-breath and relaxing back as you breathe out. And let the abdominal breathing go now into a complete breath. And feeling the breath filling the belly, filling your chest and coming all the way up to the collarbone. It's almost as if the middle of your body was like a vase. The bottom of the vase fills first, and you bring your breath up to the middle, and finally, right to the top of the vase. As it goes out, it reverses from the collarbone to the chest to the belly with its own rhythm, like the tide filling the belly, filling your chest, filling your collarbone, and receding like the tide from the collarbone to chest to belly. It becomes more and more effortless to observe the natural tide and rhythm of the breath, as if it had a life of its own that you can trust and begin to follow now, noticing in your own way, that the body rises so gently on the in-breath and relaxes back as we breathe out. Enjoy counting back from 10 to 1 as we did before. You might try it silently now, breathing in, and then as you breathe out, mentally imagining 10, 9, 8. Every out-breath is an opportunity to let go, to relax a little bit more, to let yourself sink down and feel the comfortable heaviness and warmth of your body. Allow the chair to support you completely and bring yourself into the arms of gravity, into the arms of Mother Earth. Thank you. When you breathe out, you can follow your breath now into your own inner silence. And as you relax, you can follow your breathing into the storehouse of special memories and places. Travel through your mind to the meadows of your innermost being, to a sunlit clearing, fresh with the mild, fragrant breezes of spring. As you breathe, you can relax into the warmth of the sun and feel the gentle wind caress your body and your face and ruffle your clothing. You can attune yourself more and more to the delightful sights and sounds and fragrances. Feel the softness of the grass underneath your body. The shimmer of light through the trees. The soothing scents and warm colors of the flowers all around you. Rose. Yellow, purple, and blue. The birds and butterflies play with the breeze. The wonderful abundance of life in the meadow. And the sounds of the crickets and the wind in the leaves. Beyond the green rolling hills, see the gentle clouds slowly drifting toward the distant horizon, clearing the sky completely, letting yourself lazily drift along into the blue, and hear the whispering sound of a stream down below. Feel the wonderful freshness of the clear water gently running through your fingers, and the welcoming coolness, the drops of water now on your face. Inhale the delicate fragrance of the earth and of this beautiful sunny day. Feel yourself smiling as you breathe and roll slowly into the tender caress of the grass. And now you can feel the peace here in this special place, and the life force of the awakening spring, and you can feel the life force within your body now. Feel it resonating with the meadow. Feel it as a current of inner joy. And the meadow is a sacred place of comfort, security, stillness and rest, a place of safety, truth and peace, a warm place of wisdom within yourself, to which you can always come. And within the meadow are many special places you can discover. Places where you can feel your own sense of power. Places where you can feel especially cozy and safe. Places of peace as you practice coming to this special place within yourself. Discover the potential, the beauty, and the wisdom dwelling always within you. You trust yourself. And you trust in God, and you connect with all the positive energy within you, like a shining light, and you see it radiating out of you on your breath, flowing out into the horizon, into infinity, all your potential, all your power, all your optimism, never ending. And relax. And watch it pass again out of your grasp no hold on you. And you feel free. And you feel limitless potential, like the sea, like the sky. You feel the power, the center of your being radiates out like the sun with 1,000 rays, and you stay within yourself, secure, safe, and warm, silent. And now, for the next few minutes, we're going to let go into that inner silence. Let go of the images. Let go of everything but the breath. Just follow it simply and quietly. And if you like, focus your awareness on a special word, allowing that focus to repeat itself in time to the flow of your breath. I will leave you alone in silence for that next few minutes, with an occasional reminder to follow your breath. Focus on the breath. Peace is within you. Remain in the silence. Enjoy this moment of stillness. In this sanctuary of wisdom, be aware. Wherever your thoughts are, let go and return to your breath. Return to your focus and know that you're safe inside your breathing and inside yourself. Inside your soul, and inside, you trust yourself, and you trust in the goodness of things, in the nature of things, and you know that you carry this safe place inside yourself all the time, wherever you go, and you take this safe place, this secret place, with you. You can take it with you now and further continue your inner journey. Or you can take it with you now, slowly, back into the physical world, the material world, very, very gently, without any effort. You're in contact with yourself, with your spirit, with your soul, your innermost being. And you don't have to do anything. Bring yourself with you. Bring your confidence, your inner peace, your security. And now allow yourself to return slowly to the room. And using the breath as your bridge, you can take a couple of deep breaths now. And notice how the quality of your breath has changed. Take this calm and positive energy with you. And know that whenever you want it, all you need to do is stop and reconnect. It's always there, always will be. Now you might find that you like to take a stretch and allow yourself to come back gradually as you reorient yourself and prepare to go on about your day.